I'm here with Jacy, Sam Hill's mechanic, to talk tyres. So Jacy, how important is tyre choice and what tyres the team running this season?
This season we'll be using Michelin tyres. Got a bunch of different models to try out during the year, and tyre choice is one of the most important things that you need because it's your contact between the ground and your bike, so it's one of the most important things on your bicycle. So we have a few different models here for this week for us to test out while we're here at Windrock Bike Park.
Okay.
So far we've been running the Michelin Wild Enduro front and rear combo. This being the front, you can see it's pretty aggressive tread, bigger blocks, super soft rubber, and so it's just awesome for grip on any type of terrain really. Okay. Even this model has been great, even though, because it's been wet and dry at the same time, and it's been a great tire for those conditions.
Perfect all-rounder then?
Yeah, good all-rounder, especially, you know, you don't want to be out there changing your tires when you're here on an average weekend.
Yeah.
So it's great to have a tire that works for everything, does everything well.
Yeah.
So it's been a really good tire for the week.
And it's that kind of performance that Sam and the boys will be looking for during an Enduro World Series.
It is, because you need consistency in your tires, right? Like, you can't have a tire, there is no time in a race day generally to change tires. Mm-hmm. So there can be varying conditions. You can start out dry, you can go wet, you can have multiple types of terrain in an Enduro race.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they do go such big distances. So yeah, it's good to have a tire that kind of does everything well.
Yeah, yeah. And as we've seen this weekend, the conditions have changed a lot. Yesterday with bone dry up there.
Yeah, yeah, it's gone from bone dry. Like, we started, it was a bit muddy, and then it was bone dry, then it rained a little bit. Now today it's decided that it just needs to rain all day long. And you've got hard pack, you've got clay, you've got slick slab rocks, which are usually really slippery when it gets wet, and a mud tire might not be the best on that type of terrain, especially from the rocks. So using these Wild Enduros has been really good.
Okay.
He was also using the Wild Enduro rear, which is, if you look at it, same idea on the tread pattern, but what they've done is they've shrunk the knobs down, brought them closer together, a little bit faster rolling. It's a little bit smaller, but it's pretty much the same size tire. So you get a little bit more efficiency out of the tire itself, and it's also a different rubber compound. So you've got a center knob that's a bit firmer, which also helps with rolling.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you can't be dragging around heavy, slow tires all the time. You do need grip, but at the same time, you do need some efficiency.
So it's a good balance.
It is a good balance, and we're gonna play with putting the Wild Enduro front tire, front and rear, and see how that works out, what the feedback's gonna be, whether it's worth the trade-off of rolling resistance versus how much extra grip it's gonna give us.
Yeah,
so we'll do that later today and tomorrow.
And so, mud options?
Well, we also have the Wild Mud, which is this aggressive one here.
You can see the difference already.
Yeah, you can see, you know, big open tread pattern, tall side knobs, tall center knobs with gaps. One of the nice things they do is they put these little cut ledges in them. So if it dries out a bit, or you're dealing with terrain that's a little bit more hard pack, but you still think you need a mud tire, you can trim them down, get a little bit different variation on the model of tire. These are going to be a good tire for when it gets sloppy out there.
And was there a race last year that you could have seen yourselves using the mud tire?
Yeah, like in Ireland, in Wicklow, that would have been a good one to use them. The thing is with the Enduro is you got to ride all day long, and dragging these tires around is difficult, but it could pay off in each stage, so you have to decide, you know, what's going to work best for you. It also depends on the conditions. If it's raining, constantly, a lot of the times you don't need a mud tire because everything's just wet. It's not necessarily claggy, but then when it starts stops raining and people are rotting the tracks, then it gets sticky and gooey, and then you need something that's going to clear out instead of getting just caked full of dirt.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.